I'm here at the Outlaws Boxing Club in Tarzana, California, talking to Brandon Krause, Kronk T-shirt today. Brandon, we're going over this list. People always ask me, how can they increase power? How do they use power?
Well, here at Outlaws, the focus of the month of February is going to be about power. Hitting hard, commitment, everything associated with a good, forceful shot. And here we have some bullet points on the board. Some things, some cues I want my fighters to remember, some things that I have some verbal and some drills to back up. Well, let's start at the first thing. Intention to hit hard. You know, sounds simple enough. You want to hit somebody hard. Well, you have to intend to hit hard. But as people who have experience around boxing know, that isn't always the case. You know what I mean? A lot of guys are boxing around the 60-70% mark, and they're wondering why they're not hurting people, because they don't go out there with the intentions of throwing punches for the sake of damage. They go out there with the intentions of just landing, right? And there's a big difference. There's a big difference about your commitment level between the two, between, you know, just being a guy who's looking to tap and looking to for being a guy who's looking to whack.
Okay.
Anyways, punch deep into through the target. You know, this kind of plays off that first bullet point that I got up there. That if I want to hit as hard as I can, I'm going to have to aim a little bit deeper than just to make contact. I'm going to have to aim so deep where, again, you know, it's going to sound brutal, but where my punch becomes a damaging blow. What I tell people is, you know, I wouldn't say like it's always aimed 3 inches into the target, because every target's going to be different. Every situation is going to be different. But you definitely, you know, if you're trying to punch me in the nose, you wouldn't stop right at my nose. You would actually want to punch through me to really get as much as you can out of that shot. So that's what that means.
Okay.
Here's another thing. Knuckles. This is a very easy thing to do to improve your punching power that a lot of people forget what to do. And look, what it is you want to position your fists in a way that your knuckles are the thing that's driving in. That all that power, all that, who knows, you know, 2,500 pounds of PSI that you can create with your body, eventually gets coiled into just the smallest point of your front and middle knuckle and make that into like a piercing.
But not every fighter punches with knuckles. I've seen fighters who punch with the palm or punch. Why don't they do that? Why? I'm talking about champions, the highest level fighters.
Well, look, gloves inherently open up your hands inside and make you kind of want to punch this way. And I bet you those same guys that you see not punching with knuckles probably don't have the greatest knockout records and things like that, because that is the difference between landing the shot and getting rid of your guy, all right? Those small things that you can do that can help you transfer power, you know, give force to your opponent instead of just generate force, all right?
Brandon, do I just need to practice when I hit the punching bag about knuckles? Just practice when I do pads?
No, unfortunately, a lot goes into just these things I have on the board. So I can tell you 1,000 different things you can do to help you practice throwing with your knuckles.
Give me one, not 1,000.
Starting with hitting the bag with just your hand wraps on sometimes, all right? Not having that comfort zone of a padded glove. Having to really position your fist in a way where that damaging part of your bones is what's striking first. That's one way. How about push-ups on your knuckles? That's another good way. How about taking a little extra time in your shadow boxing and in your basic training regime in general to make sure that your knuckles are what's aiming first? That means, look, my fist on its own isn't going to produce that. When I just go like this, you know, you see it's like my fingertips that want to hit. I have to intentionally point it down. But what does that do? That gives me a straight line in which that power is going to be best absorbed. I don't want to hit this way and risk bending my wrist, hurting it, bending it, risking it that way. It's got to be that perfect place where it all lines up. Tight fist, all right? This absolutely plays into knuckles, all right? You hit with your hand open. First of all, you are not going to create a surface that's going to generate power, that's going to transfer power. Second of all, you're probably going to hurt your hand. You're probably going to hurt your hand pretty darn bad if you get into the habit of punching with your hands open. So tighten that fist. Make sure that your knuckles are what's landing first.
One question.
Yes.
When you're on defense, you're now defending yourself, Coach Brandon Krause. Are your palms open or shut, like ready to punch again?
No, your hands are open, and even, you know.
Can I ever have them all closed?
You certainly could. It's going to be to your detriment. It's going to make your moves slower, more forceful. It's going to use more energy. It's going to take longer if you always have your hands clenched, all right?
But think about it. It's easier to
No, actually, you're wrong, Ellie. It's easier to throw your hand when it's open, and then at the last second, close and tighten your fist. And that's, you know, one of the tricks that true power puncher wants to master, is to have their hand open and loose until that last second, boom! And then tighten up that power and center it in. And then, you know, put all these other things that we just talked about, knuckles, tight fist, twisting, all that stuff.
What's five is twisting. What's six?
Transferring weight, okay? Now, look at this. If boxing was just a pure world of mathematics and it was more like fencing or the Olympic style, you know, I would always be on balance. It'd always be about just landing my blows like I was talking about before, stepping in, never having any transfer of my weight, right?
Mm-hmm.
But anyone who's ever seen like tapes of Ray Robinson, you know, putting his whole body into some shots, know that sometimes when you got to do it on Queer Street, you want to commit that weight to really generate some forceful power. Let's say I was throwing the right hand. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to, instead of being absolutely perfect and keeping my weight even 100% of the time, I'm going to throw my weight forward to my left foot, snapping the right hand. Let's say I wanted to come back with the left hook. Well, now I'm going to throw my weight to my right foot, whop, and snap the hook. What are the advantages of this? Well, just like what we're talking about, that's how you can have devastating force. That's how you can really throw some damaging shots. What are the disadvantages of this? Well, I am so committed to these punches, it's going to be very difficult for me to defend or to counter or to deal with anything dynamic other than just pounding this dude in the chin.
Brandon, can you give me those two punches another time? I'm just going to get a wide shot so people can see your footwork.
Okay, yeah, and look, I'm talking about a very committed punch here. Here comes the right hand. My weight's even as I set up. I'm going to step big with my left foot. I'm going to throw my weight to my left side, and the right hand is going to follow that, okay? And I'm going to come back with that left hook. I'm going to take my weight, and I'm going to throw it to my back foot, my right foot, and throw that left hook. Really committed, get those knuckles, tighten the fist, everything we talked about previously, and end up back into my stance.
Okay, number seven.
Proper timing, all at the same time. Well, what we're talking about is, the knockout is such a beautiful thing. The knockout is such is poetry in motion.
I hope one day to do it so I can experience it.
You will experience it, Segback. I'll put somebody up there in front of you. But what is so beautiful about the knockout is there, for 1,000 different fighters, there's 1,000 different ways that they knock people out, all right? For every beautiful, long Tommy Hearns right hand that we've ever seen, you know, there's the equally impressive Pepito Cuevas looping left hook, right? For every Shane Mosley wax to the body combination blowing dudes out at lightweight, there was also the Ricardo Mayorgas that came and clubbed, right?
The Marquez.
Yeah, or the Marquez counterpunch, or the Manny Pacquiao thunder of a left hand. What are these all have in common? They're all completely different techniques from completely different fighters. Well, here's what they have in common. They timed them the correct way. They put the opening that they saw, the power they knew how to deliver, the way to deliver that force, all into the proper place in time and space, all right? I know it's sounding a little philosophical now, but that's really what the knockout is. It's such a culmination of so many things coming together. You would never be able to say it's this one point. It's, oh, he's tall. Oh, his shoulders are broad. Oh, his hands are big. No, I wish it was that easy, but it's not. You got to put together 1,000 things to consistently be able to hurt and knock out your foes.
I saw Mickey Ray do that in Vegas this weekend. Exactly what you just described. He timed it, and he knocked his opponent out.
That's how it works. Relax. Be fast, all right? Tense people rarely produce any useful energy and force in the ring. You have to be loose and relaxed, okay?
Okay.
And the last thing is the kinetic chain. And what is the kinetic chain? Well, that's fancy vocabulary for meaning timing and linking together your movements to create that energy, right? Just like I said, for the right hand, you know, it was step and twist and throw and transfer the weight. It's not this. It's not all at the same time, right? I don't just take everything that's going to be moving and fire it at the same damn time. No, it's a beautiful, coordinated effort from my feet, out my body, and through my fist.
There you have it, Brandon Krause, with a beautiful explanation about power. Stay tuned in the Outlaws Box of Interns and for EsNewsReporting.com and my Segback Reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Segback. Take a step back, cause it's Ellie's setback.